Hey YouTube, what's up? Daniel here from Twin Bytes. I got something new for you today. Well, besides my new look, which is a little odd from usual, but you'll know what this is all about in a moment as we zoom out. And today we're talking about Skype and how you can save money with long distance calls on that. Possibly even replace your entire phone system with this service. Now, it's not recommended, and they actually say so on their website, but this is for those people that are totally new to this thing and they want to know how to what is it, where is it, how to get started. So I'm going to show you how to get here in a moment. First thing you want to do is basically go to skype.com. Now when you type in skype.com and hit enter, it just automatically fills in the rest of this. And first go to the download tab here, okay. Once you're on here, scroll down a bit and download now. Now this is basically for the free edition for personal use. If you're for business, there's some other stuff you can do, but you can read about it on their website, and actually there's a tab right here that says for business, so you can find out about that. There's another version you can use, which you can always add to it later, so you can start with this free one and add the business to it later if you want, which is what I've done, so that you can have multiple people on the same account. So if you get this message at the top here, you want to click on it and say download the file, and it starts to download it. You can just hit run because it's a very small file. And of course, if you're using Vista or Windows 7, you'll get a message like this. You want to hit yes. And then you're into the installation. So very simple. Choose your language and agree and install. And if you want, you can include the Google Chrome. Normally with installation of any program, they have these things turned on and you have to turn it off. Now I already have it installed, so this may be because I've already got it installed that it's turned off. So just double check that and make sure it's checked on or off, whatever you want, and then continue installing Skype, and then it's going to go through it, and this part can take some time. And if you could hear that at all, that's the sound of Skype starting up. So now it's up, and it shows the little icon down by the time, and actually I can see one of my contacts is telling me is online. And now what would happen, let's just see if I can quickly get out of here. Because I already had an account, it took me right in. This is what it would do for you. You would have this screen where you can create an account or sign in if you do have an account. So if you have an account, type in your username and password. If you're doing this for the first time, you would click on don't have a Skype name. Then you would be able to fill in the username, password, you know, create one. It'll check and see if it's available, and if it is, you'll keep going, follow the prompts, and you're in. I already have an account, so I'm just going to log in, so don't look as I type my password. And sign me in when Skype starts, and start Skype when the computer starts, so it's going to be all automatic. And that's it, I'm in. So there's a few basic things that you can do. Go to create a new contact, and you can find people based on their Skype name if you know what it is, and minus twinbytesinc if you wanted to look me up and send me a message or do a video call with me or something, just try it out. I'm pretty busy, but who knows, I just might answer. You can put in their actual name or their email address and search for them that way. Now, down at the bottom here, you can see that you can also add people from your email address books. So if you go in there, it'll check your entire address book of whatever program it is that you're using and upload them all for you. And you can choose it from here, which type of address book, or if it's under other, like in my case, Microsoft Outlook. And then it'll import everything from there. Once you have the names, if you click on someone, you can then call them at their home number or do a video call to that person. And basically it'll ring on their computer, they answer it, and if you have webcams, you can both see each other at the same time while you're talking to each other. And all you need is a headset like you saw me wearing earlier. And you can get them pretty cheap just about anywhere. And it's got a microphone boom on it, so that way you can talk as well as listen without going through the speakers where everyone can hear what's going on. So it can still be a private phone call. And you can do regular calls to anyone, so they don't... Okay, if they have Skype, you can call them anywhere in the world for free by calling their Skype account. If they don't have a Skype account, then you can call their number once they're imported into your address book. Now, there's a tab down here to call phones. So then you can basically type in whatever the phone number is and call that number. And it'll ring on their house phone or cell phone, wherever you're calling, and they'll talk to you normal, but of course you'll be through the computer. Now, the only thing weird is they may not answer your call because they're going to see a number that reads 0123456789, and that just looks weird. So if you ever received a call like that from that number and you have call display, you probably won't answer it, right? Same thing with them, so you might have to call back again. Oh yeah, there's one more thing that I want to show you. If you click on Tools and go to Options, this is where a lot of things are that you might want to change, and you may have to go in here to fix some stuff. Audio settings, your microphone. If you have two different microphones, make sure the right one is selected. Same with the speakers. If you have two different, if you got your headset and then you've got your desktop speakers, do you want them to come out of the speakers that are attached to your computer, or do you want them to come out of the headset that you're wearing? So that way, if you're talking to someone and you got a group of you around, maybe doing a conference call, you want it to come out of the speakers of the computer, not out of the headset, so this way everyone can hear. And the ringing, ring on all devices, which means ring through the headset as well as through the speakers on the computer. And you can choose one or the other as well. That's basically it. I know with my wife's computer we had a problem with the video, actually. So that's the next part. If you go down to video, hello. And with this part here, if you have a problem where if you can basically see yourself in this window, then you know everything is fine. But if you don't see yourself in this window, there may be a problem with the way the video is set up. All right, that's it for Skype, and hopefully you guys can try it out. Contact me, message me with it, let me know, hey, it worked. Don't forget to comment below, subscribe, rate the video, and that's it. If you have any questions, technical questions that you'd like me to answer, just post a question on my channel wall, and or even post a video response to any one of my videos, and then I'd be happy to do something for you there. All right, thanks a lot, guys. Take care. Bye for now.